Right friends, welcome back to third capsule. This is on farmers' distress. Tamil Nadu was declared as a drought state, and because of the failure of northeast monsoon, farmers suffered badly. And in this context, we are going to deliberate on farmers' distress. And during the editorial discussion, we discussed certain aspects, and I added some more aspects here, and this will be useful in future also, because you can add these points whenever you are presenting pertaining to Indian agriculture. If you are presenting an essay or article pertaining to Indian agriculture, this article will be immensely benefiting you. And the factual information is, India witnessed two consecutive years of drought, 2014 and 15, but this year 2016 is the year of normal rainfall during the Kharif season. Another important aspect is, India gets 80% of the rainfall from southwest monsoon and around 20% from northeast monsoon. And if you look at the Tamil Nadu, the southern state, here the state is predominantly dependent on northeast monsoon, and this year there is a failure of northeast monsoon. That's why Tamil Nadu was badly affected. That is one reason. Second reason is non-availability of water in Kaveri river basin. This because of these two reasons, Tamil Nadu was affected badly, and Tamil Nadu was declared a drought hit. And because of official declaration of drought, then the result will be loan recovery will be postponed, land taxes will be waived, and schemes like Mahatma Gandhi Narega will be implemented. But that is not enough. Exactly what are the problems faced by Indian agriculture sector? We are going to throw some light on that. Problems faced by agriculture in general. Small land holdings. In India, the biggest problem is small land holdings of 1 acre, 2 acres, and farmers are doing subsistence agriculture. Subsistence agriculture is basically the agriculture where their bare minimum needs are met. Then there is not much surplus for the growth of the family, growth of the individual. So many Indian families are dependent on subsistence agriculture, small land holdings, and they are further bifurcated because of 2 children, 3 children, and because of the population. Because of the population increase, you can say the land holdings are becoming further subdivided into small and small. Then second point is the green revolution of 1960s and 1970s. Famous persons you should not forget, the agriculture minister Subramaniam, and at the same time Norman Borlaug, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, Indira Gandhi the prime minister. Because of the efforts of all these people, green revolution of 1960s benefited, but there are some drawbacks. Green revolution of 1960s and 70s benefited only few crops and benefited only few areas, right? And more lands are being cultivated by tenant farmers nowadays. Tenant farmers are cultivating more and more lands, and the biggest drawback is this institutional mechanism of loans is not available to the tenant farmers. Tenant farmers are not able to access loans from banks or cooperative banks. That is the biggest problem. They are dependent on informal loans from money lenders at exorbitant high rates, right? So if you look at the green revolution, the advantages are self-reliance in food grains, and country became food secure, and farmers' incomes were raised, and the need to change land use to agriculture was minimized. These are the positive aspects, and negative aspects not reached all the regions. The biggest disadvantage is not reached all the regions. Only certain areas with assured irrigation are benefited. Only certain crops are benefited. And another drawback is groundwater table has gone down because of excessive use of water for irrigation purposes through tube wells. Groundwater table has gone down, and with the excessive use of fertilizers, soil fertility was lost. So these are the drawbacks of green revolution, but the positive side is we became self-reliant in food grains. But the biggest problem is it has not touched dry crops. That is the biggest problem. And the second problem is this green revolution has not touched all the areas, and now the immediate need of the hour is to have second green revolution, basically to benefit rain fed crops, dry land crops, pulses. So this is the need of the hour, and the second green revolution should look at all these aspects, right? And if you look at further aspects, as I have already told you, tenant farmers are worst affected because they do not have access to institutional credit from banks. And the next point is farmers are doing agriculture with more and more water guzzling crops like rice, sugar cane, and the government's policies are also supporting the cultivation of rice, sugar cane instead of other drought resistant crops. The need of the hour is to look at the pulses for the protein security of the country, to look at crops like ragi, jawar, basra, because they consume less water. So nowadays the need of the hour is to look at coarse cereals, or you can say dry crops, which require less water. But our government policies are basically supporting crops like sugarcane, rice with minimum support prices, and farmers' inclination is towards the cultivation of these crops but not dry crops. That is the biggest irony. And the next point is even in water guzzling crops like rice also, there are innovations. One example is system of rice intensification or SRI. System of rice intensification or SRI, this cultivation has not percolated down the line. It is highly water efficient, and we are concentrating on traditional conventional rice crop, but we are not concentrating on this SRI rice cultivation or system of rice intensification, which requires less water. Then the next point is protected irrigation facilities are there in our country to only 40% of the areas, and 60% is rain dependent. And nowadays government is making some effort with the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana. So 60% is rain dependent, and this needs to be improved. The areas under protected irrigation must be increased. Then the development of rain dependent agriculture with emphasis on seeds of drought resistant variety is the need of the hour. As I have already told you, our research has not gone in that direction. Research must go in the direction of rain dependent agriculture, basically dry crops, and seeds must be drought resistant, right? So irrigation facilities, as I have already told you, they are available only for 40 to 45% of the area, and the need of the hour is to look at crops like basra, then jowar, then ragi, sorghum, because they consume less water, and the productivity of these crops so as to benefit the farmers must be improved. That is possible only with more R&D and at the same time with second green revolution, right? Pulses, another area of concern is pulses. We are not self-sufficient in pulses. We are scarce. That means what I mean to convey is we are deficient by around 6 to 7 million tons. We are importing pulses. So pulses also consume less water, and more research has to go for production of pulses. Then the next point is proper linkages with the market are not available. And in most of the cases, farmer is being exploited, and throwing tomatoes onto the roads is a common sight. Tomatoes price in some seasons per kg go up to just 50 paise per kg. Farmers are not getting even transportation costs. Something needs to be done in the marketing of agriculture. then youth are not interested in agriculture, and migration to urban areas further compounded the woes of agriculture, with elder people remaining in the villages. Nowadays, youth are not interested in taking up agriculture. Then another problem is the cultivation of cotton crops, especially in Deccan areas of Maharashtra as well as Telangana, resulted in suicides of several farmers. And in most of the cases, farmers went into indebtedness due to their groundwater table going much deeper and deeper day by day. Because of that, farmers have gone into indebtedness, and subsequently they have gone to the extreme step of suicides. Then the next one is, after new economic policy, agriculture not received desired support. And this is another reason for agrarian distress. Then poor quality of seeds further accentuated the problem. The quality of the seeds is not up to the mark. Then subsistence nature of agriculture made it unviable. This is another reason. Then mechanization of agriculture has not taken roots on the expected lines. So these are all the problems faced by agriculture in general. How to mitigate the distress? Dr. M.S. Swaminathan recommended the establishment of Monsoon Management Center. Monsoon Management Center will basically look at maximizing the yield in good monsoon, and at the same time would help use of scarce resources conservatively during drought periods. Right? Then there would be mechanism to preserve the health of cattle and other livestock. Basically, in times of agrarian distress, worst affected is livestock. Please look into this picture. Worst affected is livestock in times of distress, and here support is very much essential. Center should support through National Disaster Response Fund and Prime Minister's Crop Insurance Scheme. Right? So this is another important area. If you look at further aspects, a decade ago, National Commission on Farmers pointed out four reasons for farmers' suicides. One is successive droughts. Second one is illness, because proper medical facilities are also not available in rural areas. Then the next point is high expenditure on social obligations. Then the fourth point is loss of assets. When they are into debt trap, they have to sell land. Because of these four reasons, farmers are being pushed towards the extreme step of suicides. And government should look into these aspects, and a mechanism must be evolved to solve the above mentioned problems. And center should ensure updation of drought management manual, and it should reflect the present day realities. It should give weightages to the amount of rainfall deficit, that is one aspect. It should declare a drought without delay. When rainfall deficit is there, that should be considered for giving some relief. Then the next important aspect is tanks must be revived. Tanks are not given due importance. Basically, tanks are required basically to recharge groundwater, and because of the availability of water in tanks, agrarian rural distress will be reduced. Next, make water harvesting mandatory in our country. Water harvesting must be made mandatory. And the next point is conserve water with the check dams wherever possible. Right? So these are the aspects, especially to mitigate the distress in rural areas. So we discussed at length about various problems faced by Indian agriculture in general and recent problems in particular. Right, friends, this is the third capsule, and please do join for why and how and facts and figures. With this, we are concluding second week's modules. Have a nice day. Thank you. Thanks a lot.